Well, Blair, for telling your story, you get the coveted Raw Deal t-shirt.
Great. Thank you.
There you go.
Thanks.
Blair, before we get started, tell us a little bit about yourself.
I'm a local artist. I've been practicing for about the last 8 years.
So what do? You paint?
I paint. Actually, my walls here is a good example of the kind of work that I do. Joint compound and house paint mm-hmm. on very large scale.
So you submitted your story. What happened?
In November 2008, my mom decided to replace my freestanding tub in my master bath. I was in pretty bad shape. It was a birthday combined Christmas present.
Well, that's
it was
a nice gift.
Yeah, $1,500 worth.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. And the configuration of the tub changed from end mounted on the tub to side freestanding drain, you know, the whole thing changed, the configuration changed. So because of that, I decided to get better plumbing and piping because it's exposed.
It would be exposed.
Right.
Yeah. So you want nice looking stuff in your bathroom, right?
Right. I got oil rubbed bronze,
oh.
Which cost me about $1,000 just for the plumbing, you know. So I had a handyman that I used for years, and he did great work. He rebuilt my porch, my closet, did some minor plumbing for me.
So this was all at different times that you used this handyman?
Mm-hmm, over several years.
Oh, okay. You've known him quite a while.
Yeah.
All right.
So we had talked about it, and he was going to do my bathroom. He sounded like he knew what he was going to do. So after the first day, you know, he seemed a little shaky, fumbling around, you know. I wasn't sure he really knew what he was doing, but I gave him the benefit of the doubt because of his past work, you know. Another day went past, and when he announced that he was done, I went in there and looked at it, and it was just a mess. It was leaking and crooked. The plumbing was crooked.
Uh-huh.
The piping, you know.
Yeah, because all this stuff is exposed. It should look good.
Exactly.
Because when you come in, you want to see nice looking, and you spend $1,000 on the plumbing.
Right.
And it was all crooked.
And he used metal wrenches on the oil rubbed bronze.
So he scratched them.
Scratched it really bad.
Oh, that's a big no-no, yeah.
Yeah. The shower ring that holds the shower curtain was falling out of the ceiling, plaster falling out of the ceiling.
So was he still here when you noticed all of that stuff?
Yes.
What
well,
did you
I mean,
think?
You walk in and you see it, you know.
And was he standing there like a proud puppy, like, I finished?
I couldn't even look at him. I mean, he would. I have a hard time hiding my emotion, and he would have seen it in my face.
Uh-huh.
I mean, he used 2x4s to put between the wall and the plumbing to stabilize the plumbing. So there was 3 or 4 pieces of 2x4. Just nailed to the, screwed to the wall or out.
Unbelievable.
So, I pretty much just wanted him to walk away from the situation. I didn't want to say anything because I knew that he would want to try to correct the situation.
And then he had already messed it up so much, you didn't want him touching it anymore.
I did not want him touching it anymore. So I paid him.
You paid him the money?
Paid him to walk away from the plumbing, yes.
What did you end up doing?
I got an estimate from a friend of a friend that's in the business, and it came in at $1,200 to fix the mess.
Mm-hmm.
And I took a chance with him because that's what I could afford.
Yeah.
And he did a great job.
Oh, he did a good job.
He did.
You felt like you got your money's worth for that type of repair.
Yes.
Or actually, he reinstalled the whole thing.
Right. He had to take it out. And
I forgot, did you mention what the plumber's name was that did the great job?
The guy that ended up fixing it for me that did a wonderful job, his name is Romeo Ibanez. It's Romeo Ibanez Remodeling and Plumbing.
Well, Blair, thank you for telling us your story.
Sure.
Now it's up to you to vote on who you think got the rawest deal. Will it be story number one, story number two, or story number three?